Hi everyone, my name is Johan and I'm a senior cloud developer advocate working at Microsoft. This is the first of a series of short videos for learning Node.js from the absolute beginning with a strong focus on practice. If you're a complete beginner to Node.js, that's a very good place to start. The only prerequisite is that you need to know the basics of JavaScript. So in case you also want to learn JavaScript, there's a link in the video description to a video series that's made just for that. If you don't know JavaScript at all, I really recommend that you start with JavaScript first and then come back to this Node.js video after. So back to this Node.js series. You can either follow all the video at once, like a full course, or just pick one or a few as you need. In every video, you'll find links to additional resources to follow, docs, tutorials, or GitHub repositories to help you improve your skills. And now to start with the main subject of this first video, let me introduce you my friend Wasim here.
Hi, I'm Wasim. I'm a senior cloud advocate here at Microsoft.
So Wasim, can you explain to us what's Node.js?
Node.js is a JavaScript runtime, which means that you can use it to run and execute JavaScript outside of the browser.
And what kind of applications can you build with it?
You can actually use Node.js to build server-side applications, CLI apps, web APIs, and even desktop applications using Electron. But Node.js is very popular in the IoT ecosystem, so you can use it to build JavaScript programs and deploy them on IoT boards, and the list goes on and on.
Then I'm wondering why you might need Node.js at all. Isn't there already a bunch of other tech that you can use exactly for that?
Of course, you can use any tools instead. But what is great about Node.js is that it's free and it's open source, and there is a huge open source community supporting the project. And because Node.js runs JavaScript, and JavaScript is an event-driven language, it makes it ideal to run IoT programs and even serverless APIs.
Oh, I love that. And also the fact that Node.js is also cross-platform, and that's also why I'm mostly using Node.js these days. Thank you, Wasim, and see you all in the next videos to learn about how to get started with Node.js.